In this video, we're going to talk about how to set up your Flutter Flow account and looking at the dashboard of Flutter Flow. Let's get into it. So first of all, you're going to go to flutterflow.io and you're going to click start for free. Now, this is going to allow you to create an account and you can use your Gmail account or whatever account you'd like, but more importantly, it's free. So once you get started, you will be taken to this screen when you first open it up. It will ask you a little bit about yourself. You can let them know some of the details. And then afterwards, you're going to be able to see this screen. Now let's approach this from left to right. So we're going to start on the left side right here where we can see projects. Projects allow you to create a new project or a new application that you want to do. For my organization, this allows you to have a lot of the different features if you're working with a team. Now, there's a whole other video talking about the pricing tier and things like that and what you can and cannot do based on different things. But if you're working with a team, you're going to be able to have team code library. You're going to have the media assets and design library. Basically, this allows you to scale and create applications a lot quicker. So instead of doing it from scratch or trying to just duplicate projects and losing where everything is, this is where you can really accelerate that process by using the organization tab right there. Next up, we have the marketplace. Now, when you click that, that allows you to get different elements or different templates from the marketplace. So you can have different animations. You can have all different types of things, right? So if I click animation right here, it will then allow me to have different templates that have different animation right here. So it says nav bar with page and animation. So perhaps I'm looking for something very particular in an app. I might be able to find it here. But also in the marketplace, I can just get templates that I might be interested in. For example, if I want a dashboard and I don't want to build it from scratch, I want to save several hours of design, I could buy a template for a few hundred dollars. But not only that, you can buy fully functional apps that you can get, and then you're just going to need to supply the backend or supply the function to make the application smart. We'll touch on that when we get into Flutter Flow, but just bear in mind, you can have everything you need to on the design side of things. So that's the marketplace. And if you're interested in a specific type of, you know, template or something to try it out, like I mentioned before, I could say music, or I want something like Spotify. And then I can have all of these different applications. Some are paid, some are free that I can take a look at. For example, this is, let's see, Flutterfly. I think that's how I say it, right? So I can view it live. I can buy it. I can share it, all those things. And this really allows me to speed up the process if I want to design something like this. And I want to have all the elements there ahead of time without designing it from scratch. So I can click live, that button where it says live view. It's going to allow me to interact and use the application in a limited way. And I can also, again, see if this is something that I'm looking for, see the different designs, see if this is something for me, and then go from there. I can also, again, I can back out, I can click get started so I can see the full screen, and then I can also see if it's going to be light or dark mode, things like that. I can continue and experience a flow to see if this is a good application that I would like to buy or a specific element that I'm looking for to add into my project. So I can see all right here in the marketplace. So I can do template apps, pages and components right here, the song preview, play along. That's interesting. And I can do custom code right here, custom music player widget. So again, it depends on what you're looking for, but the marketplace allows you to speed up development by having these resources. Some are free, some are paid. The next one that we have, if we click resources, this allows us to see documentation, the help center, YouTube tutorials, allows us to see a bunch of things. So say for instance, I'm stuck on a very specific thing. I can look in the Flutter Flow documentation there. I could look in the in-app tutorials. I could look at their YouTube channel. Also too, I think this is really important. You can look at the Flutter Flow community. So you can talk to ones, you can sign up, express what you're dealing with. And that really allows you to get a lot of help from tons of people in the community that are active. Then if you go to the community tutorials, that allows you to see tutorials from some of the biggest, not only teachers for Flutter Flow, but influencers, things like that. And you'll see a bunch of people here, including one of my videos right here. So that just allows you, it's an old one. I did another one, but you can see it from all around, right? So this allows you to, again, have more resources, what you're trying to do. Stay in the know, what's new. And then if you have a Mac, you can have the desktop app and go from there. So you can download the Mac desktop app and build even faster. If we click community, that will take you to the community.flutterflow.io. And then also we have perks program right here. Nothing right there right now. Oh, here we go. The perks will allow you to then see if you have a Flutter Flow account, you will be able to get some of these other deals that they have with these other companies. So another perk of being part of the Flutter Flow community. It says it's up to 56K in perks. That's a lot. So that allows you to, again, get started in a way that works for you. Now, that is everything on the left-hand side. Oh, one last thing too. If you're on the free plan, you can decide to upgrade depending on what you're looking for. So I mentioned it previously, you can start for free. I would not move up unless there's specific reasons you need to go there. To get started with Flutter Flow, you do not need to pay anything. It's free. When you're doing other things, or when you're ready to, if you want to put it on the App Store, then you're going to have to need to upgrade. But if you want to do the basics, test it out, all of those things, you can use the free version right there. You can still use Firebase, which allows you to build out that that database. You can have two API endpoints. So still, if you're going to use another database, potentially, you could still use that with APIs. And APIs are just when two systems are talking to each other. And then later on, when you go to the standard, that's when you can download the code. You can do APKs and also three integration tests. Okay, that's great. And then pro, that's when you can really start, you know, scaling it up. But to get started, you can start for free. Also to mention that, I mentioned like having teams. Let me verify this with pricing. Yeah, teams, they're $70 per person. So that's when you can collaborate, do all of those things, but that's something to keep in mind as well. But again, you can start for free. So now that we have the basics of what's gonna happen in your account, let's get started and create our first project. We're going to first click create new. And this is going to allow us to decide to create something from from a blank app, or create something with a template. I'm going to actually create something with a template so we have something to work with, so we can look at some things. And then in later videos, we'll talk about starting from scratch, how to do that, and pros and cons of doing that depending on the project. But let's take a look at creating a Flutter Met app right here, right? So it has, I don't want that. Let's just do the Geek Chat. Okay, so it gives us 10 screens. And when we scroll over, it's going to give us a little bit more information about the app itself. So it's 10 screens. It has chat, authentication, fire, store, profile creation. Let's just use that to get started with that use sample. It says start building faster with free premium sample apps. Skip. Let me zoom out to see. Oh, I have to upgrade in this account to use premium apps. Okay, let me use that. Oh, okay. So to start for free, these are premium apps. We're going to start with a blank app. Let's give it a name first. Let's see. Beta test, we'll say no code MBA one. All right, so we have that. Let's create. I'm gonna try it one more time because I'm stubborn. Can I really not use it? Okay, cool. premium sample apps available on Pro and Teams plans. Interesting. Okay. Let's go create from blank. Now it says, welcome to Flutter Flow. Congrats on starting your free project. Okay. Learn more. Okay. Tour Flutter Flow. Okay. We're going to say next. And then we're going to say start building. Okay. So it says there's a new recent version. They said tap to refresh and get a new version. I'm going to do that. I always like to have the most up to date when I'm building. So it's going to think about its life. And now we're in the builder. Now let's get a lay of the land as we're about to build out something. On the left-hand side, just like the last time, on the left-hand side, we'll start on all of these different sections, and then we'll go across to the right. We'll go to the right. So left, what we have here is the build section. Think about the build section as the visual aspect of the app. So we have the different widget palette. We have the widget tree, which just allows us to have structure, seeing the structure of the application. We have the different pages of the app, and then we can also have really the storyboard to see how everything's connecting. So the build section is everything visual of our app. The next section that we see is the connect section. Now the connect section, imagine this is where all the backend is. So if we're going to use Firestore, we can do that right here. We can also have the different data types right here. We can have the app states. We can have the API calls. So if we're going to be talking to different systems, we can have this right over here. We can also have the media assets, all the different images we're using, all of the different media types. We have it right here. We have the custom code. So if we're doing that, if we're proficient in coding, or if we're working with a team and we need to have different custom actions, custom things happening in the app, we have that. We also have the cloud functions right there. Then we have this section where we can have automated tests. So if we're going to be testing things, we're seeing how everything's firing before we go, live or do anything, we can do all this in a very controlled environment and make sure everything's great as we're building. Next, we have the theme settings. And this allows you to imagine you changing the theme or the look and feel of the app at a high level. So here we can change the different aspects of the branding colors, all those things with typography. You can do all of those things here. You can have theme widgets right here. So create your theme widget styles for your project. When you update the theme widget, all instances of your widget that use this theme will be updated to the new styling, except the properties that have been explicitly set by you. So this really allows you to keep your brand streamlined, making sure everything matches all of those different things. And then also too, right here, you can have different details based on the format, what's happening, when it's mobile, tablet, landscape, desktop, all of those things. So just imagine this is almost like making the fine tuning portions right here. This helps you. Or when you're thinking about setting it up and you're already bringing in different specific colors and all those things, you can be doing this. Keep in mind, in this section and others, I'm going to highlight when you can use the AI section. So AI gen, so you can generate AI right here. So there was a preview of, hey, I want to have this a certain style. You can say this, and then it will already make that color palette for you. So there's going to be different sections as we go through this, that there are places that you're going to be able to generate using AI, but it's important that you have understand the functionality and understand how to do it manually, and then being able to use AI as an assistant later on. So now that we have gone through all the different portions of reviewing the dashboard for Flutter Flow and reviewing the dashboard as we're in a project, the next thing that we're going to be doing is breaking down the different types of widgets and what you can be doing for your project. I'll see you in the next video.